Friends, let us set aside our anxieties and fears, at least for a moment, to come together as a community of faith. May these words of hope, these heartfelt prayers, and the beautiful melodies of our sacred songs bring you joy. Welcome, everyone. Welcome to new visitors and old friends. Welcome to all who are seeking a church home, who need strength, and who want to follow in the ways of love. Welcome to old and young, to believers and questioners and questioning believers, whoever you are, whomever you love, wherever you find yourself on life's journey, you are welcome here. I'm Jonathan Morgan, Senior Minister of First Congregational Church of Eugene, and I thank you for joining us for this service of worship. If you want to learn more about our ministry and the many online opportunities we have available, and the upcoming outdoor worship services starting in July, please visit our website at fccugene.org. On this second Sunday of June, we will be celebrating the accomplishments of our recent graduates. We are very proud of one and all. Join me now in our call to worship. Your response will appear on the screen. Gathered in the love of Jesus, inspired by the movement of the Spirit, and blessed by our loving God, we come to worship with joy in our hearts. O God, Creator of all that is known and unknown, how wonderful is this creation we call life. Your majesty is the music of the great expanse of the starry skies, yet even we, children, know the gift of your presence. In the name of the healer, the provider, and the sustainer, let our gratitude and joy be made known through our words of prayer and prose. O God, Creator of all that is known and unknown, we gather now in gratitude for your great miracle we call life. Welcome, everyone.
Today we celebrate our 2021 graduates for all their amazing accomplishments. As Henry Nouwen affirms, celebration is not just a way to make people feel good for a while. It is the way in which faith in the God of life is lived out, through both laughter and tears. Thus, celebration goes beyond ritual, custom, and tradition. It is the unceasing affirmation that underneath all the ups and downs of life, there flows a solid current of joy. The graduates we celebrate today had to dig deep and summon extra courage from their hearts in order to finish strong. We recognize their hard work and perseverance. We give thanks for the blessing of having educational opportunities. Holy One, we now pray that you would send your blessing with these graduates. Give them courage to fight for what gives them hope in the world. Guide them to find that hope, immerse themselves in it, and bring it out into our world where it is so needed today. May your will be done. Amen.
Remembering this, we lift up the names of our graduates today in worship with a special feeling of pride, with an added degree of love, with an extra boost of encouragement. And no graduate recognition would be complete without a few words from Dr. Theodore Seuss from Oh, the Places You'll Go. And then things start to happen. Don't worry, don't stew, just go right along. You'll start happening too. Without further ado, please join us in celebrating Delaney Abraham, Cottage Grove High School.
Renee Brabham, Bushnell University.
Annie Capper, Oregon State University, cum laude, business major with focus on merchandising.
Caroline Capper, Sheldon High School.
John Capper, Colorado School of Mines, summa cum laude in electrical engineering with a minor in computer science.
Drew Chapman, Cottage Grove High School.
Michael Enseki Frank, Yale Law School.
Sydney Francisco, Churchill High School.
Annika Foy, South Eugene High School. Lucy Geller, Pomona College, BA in theater with minors in music and history.
Owen Grigsby, Sheldon High School.
Owen Heffelfinger, South Eugene High School.
Chasey Iredale, South Eugene High School.
Nicholas Johnson, University of Washington, Bachelor's in Mechanical Engineering.
Tyler Lara, North Eugene High School.
Davia Michaels, Laysan American School in Switzerland.
Connor Moise, South Eugene High School.
Tristan Parzakowski, North Eugene High School.
Annie Rose, Oregon State University, Master's in Student Services and Administration.
Bowden Sherlock, South Eugene High School.
Carmen Sherlock, Barnard College of Columbia University, American Studies.
Isaac Volker Morris, South Eugene High School.
Aiden Yang, South Eugene High School. May God bless all our graduates and their families, now and into the future. Amen.
Psalm 8, a modern translation by Christine Robinson. many named one beyond imagining. When I contemplate the night sky, the cosmos, which all unfolded from a speck, galaxies, stars, this beautiful earth, who are we humans that you attend to us, mere mortals in our tiny corner, and you love us? We are life come to knowing and feeling. The whole world is in our hands, plants and animals, oceans and ice caps, rainforests, atmosphere, and ecosystems. Touch our hearts, O God. Make us worthy of this trust. Help us care for this beautiful earth. No doubt you have heard someone say, maybe a friend or a loved one, that they feel the presence of God most keenly while surrounded by the beauty and splendor of nature, listening to the evening song of a robin, or taking in the grandeur of a breathtaking landscape, or witnessing the incredible expanse of the starry firmament. Or perhaps when the pound of the surf resonates in their chest. In fact, they might even say they came to know God through their encounters with the natural world. Maybe you are one of them. And no wonder. This universe, this world, this amazing state we live in, is filled with awe-inspiring, soul-stirring spectacles of nature. I can't help but feel closer to our Creator while under the spell of such wonder. Usually. Here's another counterproductive reality. I love taking pictures. Many of you know this about me. It's my passion. I especially love photographing beautiful landscapes and the people I love. And to this, well, this takes a great deal of thought and some planning. Lighting is especially important, and composition. Truth be told, good photography takes a fair amount of work and concentration. And here's the downside of such passion. I have been in some of the most beautiful places on the planet. But if you were to ask me, John, what was it like to witness those sights? How did it feel to be surrounded by such beauty? Could you feel God's presence while you were standing in the midst of such grandeur? I mean, frankly, I might be hard-pressed to answer. Frequently, I was too preoccupied with trying to capture the mystery before I had even experienced its transformative effect. A metaphor that is reflected too often in my life, I'm afraid. We have the good fortune of having close friends, Jim and Faith Fung, who live on Kauai, the Garden Island. Jim and Faith were kind enough to invite us to visit. So last Saturday, I was traversing the Nepali Kona Trail on the north side of the island. It was a spectacular day. The clouds were moving quickly overhead, so I was able to capture the beauty of that park with just the right lighting. And I did my best composing my shots. To be honest, these pictures are merely representations of something even more spectacular when seen in person. I spent 2 solid hours on that ridge, moving a mere 1,000 feet to get the best possible shot. And because I was wise enough this time to put the phone down and just take it all in as best I could, it was absolutely spellbinding. The soft breezes and sounds of birds overhead, and deep green of the mountains, and the blue of the ocean were so powerful I couldn't fully comprehend what I was witnessing or feeling. But this I do know. I felt the very presence of God standing at the edge of that canyon by just being still, truly present, engaged. It made all the difference. The wave of emotions that washed over me that afternoon brought home the reality that I was standing on holy ground. Holy ground that is on that beautiful island and just assuredly in this hometown as in every home. Friends, it is so important to just be present, to try to live beyond the confines of the thinking mind. I don't know about you, but often, too often, I'm so busy managing my life, I forget to acknowledge the great mystery that we are involved with a very mysterious force called life. And so it's important to remember to take time and to remember that we humans are known by our loving Creator, mere mortals in this tiny corner, and to feel the great blessing that still God loves us. So take time, make time to take it all in. For it is true that a rich faith journey is a growing experience filled with times of contemplation and study to deepen our knowledge of understanding. It is also a journey enriched by acts of generosity and grace that bring relief to life. Times of putting one's faith into action are essential and greatly needed in this world. And this journey is about just being aware and open to the movements of God's Spirit. Through the voice of a robin and the laughter of a child, the flowers of the field and the mountains and all their majesty, even acknowledging the Spirit that is alive in the mystery that is your life. These are all important elements of a faithful walk. So friends, as we do our best to follow in the ways of Jesus, be open fully to the mystery of life itself that is all around you. Put aside as best you can those things that distract or preoccupy your mind, and open your hearts to the incredible wonders that surround us. Breathe deeply into God's Spirit, allowing the miracle of life to take hold of you, and see what blessings might be unfolding right before your eyes. Take in the incredible mystery and marvel at the miracle of life. Your very being, your incredible presence here on earth, is part of that miracle. I will close with the wise words from an unknown author. We are slowed down. Sound and light waves, a bundle of frequencies tuned into the music of the cosmos. We are souls walking around dressed up in biochemical garments, and our bodies are the instruments in which our souls play their music. Friends, join our friend the robin and sing your song.
May the road
Now, as we close out our time of worship, may God's Spirit continue to open your eyes anew to the vastness and splendor that is all around us. May we hear and smell and see and touch God's glory evident in all of creation. And above all, let us see the beauty of our brothers and sisters, all of them created in God's image. Go now in love, to love, and with hearts ready to serve our loving God. Go in peace, my friends, and stay safe.